The topic carving. I am Amit Gupta, assistant professor with the Chitkara School of Hospitality. So you can see carving is the topic. Now today what I am going to cover in the carving would be introduction to carving. What is the carving actually? And we'll talk about different types of knife used for carving and different methods of carving. Now for carving, it is said that the food need to be carved in front of the guest. So for that we need a knife which is sharp in nature. It should not be blunt in nature, otherwise it is going to damage the tissue of the meat. Meat is carved across the groin with the exception of the saddle lamp, which is sometimes caught at right angle to the ribs. The carving fork must be hold the joint firmly as multiple pieces damages the food. The knife and the fork should be handled properly, and in one hand should be knife, in another hand should be the carving fork. Now, equipment used in carving. We need a carving knife. Carving knife has a blade of 10 to 12 inches and a width of 2.5 centimeters. The picture is already being there, so you can look at the picture. For poultry or game slice, we need a long knife for carving. For ham, long, thick, flexible knife is required and used. This is how the knife look like. It should be very sharp in nature because we have to take out thin slices of the ham. Now, methods for carving. Carving for all hot food must be performed quickly so that no heat is allowed to escape. So we need to be very fast when we are doing the carving in front of the guest. For beef and ham, thin slices are cut. If you look at the picture, this is the picture of a ham, okay, which is from the hind part, which is being sliced. Thin slices are being taken out. Now for lamb, mutton, pork, veal, tongue, double the thickness of beef and ham, we do the carving. So thickness of the beef and ham should be the double the thickness of the ham. It means if you look at the picture back, or I would say how we have taken the slice of the ham, for the beef we have to do it double the thickness, especially for lamb, mutton, pork, veal. Now methods of carving. For saddle lamb carved in long thin slices. For shoulder of lamb, it is cut from top to bottom and again from bottom to top because there is a joint in between. Okay, so that need to be carefully looked after. For boiled beef and pressed meat, it is thickened then roast. This is how it look like. For cold ham, carved bones from the bottom in thin slices, it is similar to the salami, or I would say ham, where thin slices are being taken out with the help of a carving knife. Now for whole chicken, there are 6 portions we get from the whole chicken. 2 breast piece, though 2 winglets and 2 leg pieces. For ducklings, it is carved in 6 portions, 2 legs, 2 wings and 2 breasts. For turkey, 4 cuts, the guest is supposed to be ordered breast and a supreme part along with that. For salmon, fillets and then slice into 1/4:1 inches slice. This is the trolley for the carving. So you will find out in the trolley, you already know it has got a wheel. There is one below platform which is for keeping the plates or other mise en place, and there are 2 hot plates in between which is inside the bain marie, okay, which could be curved. So in one we have the food that the meat that need to be carved, and another we have the accompaniment that need to be served along with the carved food. Okay, now carving trolley function. How does it function? The function of carving trolley is to act as an aid selling. The chef should act as a salesman and suggest right joint to right guest. The carving is visual treat. Hence, great care should be taken while doing it. Carving trolley is heated by 2 methylated gas. The container in which the carving board rests contains hot water. There are 2 each for keeping hot plates. Last one to keep carving equipments. The mise en place required for carving is carving board, carving knife and fork, sauce ladles, service gears, joint plates for dutties, flatware, spare serviette and serviette cloth. Now, method of serving a dish at the table. Present the dish to the customer, then return to the garrido. Because we have to present the food to the guest first, take his approval before we proceed to prepare the dish. Place on the side of the trolley with the food for serving stand on the hot plate. The food for service is then carved in and is placed on the plate of the guest. Now, a few of the safety points. Never place the lamp or the hot plate outside the four trolley legs. Never move the trolley near to the drapes. It might catches fire. The drapes might catches fire and could be a reason for fire or accident. Note, the main coat does not need to be placed on the hot plate. If the service is quick, only the potatoes and vegetable for a short period. It means, in case more guests has ordered for the food from the carving trolley, in that scenario, the main course is served, prepared and served to the guest, and the accompaniment is served by the server to the guest in their plates. Serve with a spoon in one hand and the fork in another, which I told you earlier also, we don't use like a service gear, but we use both the hand for serving the carving food to the guest. I hope you like this session. Thank you. Have a great day ahead. Bye-bye.